Hi everyone, Rhonda Robson with Rhonda's Tri-RRR-tistry, and in today's video I'm going to show you something that I didn't like and something of mistake that you can learn from. And the mistake is that you need to, when you are in fluid art, to make sure everything is level. Because when you go to put your canvas in the drying area and it's not level, you're not gonna get the results that you had when you put it there. So, let me show you. This was supposed to be a really cool Dutch pour, and this is more along the lines of what it was supposed to be like and what it was when I ended it, but it must have been lower in this level on this side here, because as you can see, everything ran in that direction. So I'm going to recover this in the same colors with the white background again, and you might see it in this video as well, but this is what you don't want to do, especially when you're working with a 24 by 24 canvas. You just need to make sure everything is level. So that's another tip for you, level everything. So I'm gonna show you what I did. At least you can see the Dutch pour that I did and the technique I used. I wanted to make sure these particular colors, I love the combination of them together, but when you blend them together, they create a brown, and I made that mistake in a video prior to this. And so I wanted to do it in a way that did not create brown. So when I did my Dutch pour in this one, you'll notice that I didn't put the colors together in a puddle. I didn't put them in a line. I kind of spread them out. And then instead of pouring the color, the white over top and then blowing it out, I just blew it out. So I think you're gonna like that. Unfortunately, you can't see the final results that it was because I didn't take a picture of it wet either, which is another great tip if you wanted to make sure that you capture what it looked like when you were finished with your painting. I would take a picture afterwards as well before it dries. And sometimes you never know what could happen. You could have a crack or something else could happen. Sometimes we have to hold our breath in order to get the results that we want. Thank you for joining me today, and we will get you down on the canvas so you can at least see the technique that I used for that. All right, bye for now. Don't forget to subscribe and click that notification bell. And let me know if you've had a unlevel experience down below in the contacts or in the, I can't talk today, down in the comments below. All right, bye for now. Hi everyone. All right, so today's video, we are going to be doing a Dutch pour utilizing these colors here. And they were created but with the color wheel. And this one is a tetrad with violet, red, orange, yellow, and blue green in order to create that. So it's one of these squares. So I'm gonna find it here. There it is. So it's the yellow, the blue green, the violet, and the orange red. All right, so that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna do a Dutch pour for the YMCA. We are opening the Y tomorrow after been closed with COVID for the last 11 weeks. And so we're all kind of excited. And so I thought, well, I might as well do something for that. So that's what I'm gonna be working on. So these are the colors, the violet, the green blue, the orange red, and the yellow. Those will be the colors that I'm gonna put in there. All right, I think I'm gonna have to expand this and take you up higher, so I'll be right back. All right, that's better. You're up higher now. Thank you. Love it. I haven't had a loved one in a while, so wish there's a little bit more white space, but for the most part, I really like this one. Okay, I'll be back.
Thanks for watching, and if you're new to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell so that way you can get notified when I have a new video up. Thank you for watching, and have a great day.